Following cabinet session on 18th December this year, cabinet approved the extension of the term of office of the National Women Council and of the local administrative units of LC1 and LC2 for a further period.
The extension of the term of office of women councils and women's committees existing at the commencement of the National Women Council's Amendment of Schedules, Instrument 2023, and the term of office of the local administrative units, LOC 1 and 2, from 6 January 2024 for a further period not exceeding 180 days.
Besides financial constraints, Kabianga explained why the elections have continuously been postponed.
Sometimes get administrative challenges and we can only do something when we are ready for it. Because elections is a very, very sensitive thing. It can bring about a lot of petitions if you are not properly ready. It may not necessarily be money, but other logistical challenges. So that's why we are postponing till we are ready for these elections, so that we can produce a free and fair election.
Cabinet further resolved to extend the Uganda Support Municipal Infrastructure Development additional financing following the success of the current program. A deliberate plan to upgrade 40 roads equating to 290 kilometers in refugee hosting districts was also revealed.
Cabinet also noted that under USMID AF, a grant was extended to 7 refugee hosting districts to implement 40 road infrastructure sub-projects covering a total of 290 kilometers.
Aspects to be considered in the next program include, among others, infrastructure development in the cities. You agree with me that infrastructure is the mover of these urban areas. Infrastructure facilitates growth and development in these cities and municipalities.
In a bid to overcome the burden of importing liquefied petroleum gas, the cabinet approved the application for a license to construct the LPG facility by Sinok Uganda Limited in the Kingfisher development area. This will minimize charcoal usage, among other benefits.
All the LPG that we use in Uganda is currently being imported. So it means that once we start producing this in the country, first of all, we'll increase access and use of LPG, and then also positively impact on our microeconomics by improving our balance of payment position.
On 10th July this year, Local Council 1 and 2 had to vacate office at the expiration of their term of office. This, however, never went as it ought to have been after Parliament approved the government's amendment to the third schedule of the Local Governments Act, which saw these leaders continue their official duties for an additional 6 months. Also, the Electoral Commission had requested for 56 billion Uganda shillings to organize these elections, but the Ministry of Finance did not provide for it in the budget framework paper that Parliament relied on to pass the 2023-2024 financial year's budget. This request was part of a total budget of 8 billion shillings that also includes organization of the Women Council elections from village to the national level. Derek Asaba, reporting for the news.